declare to you that the fruit of the Spirit, the gift of the Spirit, is coming your way in the name of Jesus. I say in the name of Jesus. I see the blessing.
Be faithful.
Always the faithfuls.
They
provoke God to speak for them. Be careful to talk against the faithful. Be careful to fight the faithful. And the faithful people, it's not that you won't hear bad things about them, but always God fight for them. When you insult someone who's faithful, you'll get a punishment that will be a lesson to others. When you become faithful, you become a person that God has chosen. You also preserve the strength that God has given
you.
Be faithful. The moment when you become unfaithful, you become useless. When you become faithful, you become useful. There is something that God wants to do about your life. He cannot do anything until you become faithful. You will never be anything when you are not faithful.
I see
some people here who are saying, what about if it is like this? And many of them here, they are searching for solutions of their problems. And they don't mind the source. Whatever you are going through, I want to tell you, it's checking for your faithfulness. Be faithful. Your faithfulness determines you before God. You are the one who can be accepted or rejected by God. Tithe is a very small thing. It's just part of us. It becomes part of us as Christians. Offering is a very big thing because it needs your heart. Listen to this. What is written here is written like a signboard. But what if you are failing to what is written? What more of what God will tell you? What if God said, don't even take this, give all your salary? You are failing on what is written called
tithe.
The small thing. What if God say, take all your house and give it to
me?
We are determined by the capacity of our responsibility before God. Not because of the much you have. Your faithfulness is checked where your ability and responsibility has been placed.
The
moment when you fail to be faithful, all sins follow you. Competition follow you. Pride follow you. Every sin follow you. Be faithful. It's only the faithfulness that will take you to your destiny. That doesn't mean that when you start to be faithful, people will stand with you. Expect opposition and faithfulness. Allow hunger to beat you up. As long as you have got right standing with God. Allow challenges to come your way. Because when they do that, they are temporary. Whatever you are going through when you are faithful is temporary. Tell them, whatever you are going through when you are faithful is temporary. Tell your neighbor. Whatever you are going through when you are faithful is temporary. We love to solve our challenges
very fast.
In an unfaithful
way.
When you start to feel
like you're not feeling right, you're not feeling right. You want to solve your sickness in the wrong way. We are exposed to quick results. That is why many of us, we are deceived.
That is why we fail.
Many of us who have been deceived because we are so fast. We don't mind the source. Be faithful. Faithfulness make you to be patient.
How when out separala, we are leader.
You are able to be patient.
We are hona leader.
Number two.
Sabobidi.
It makes you to endure.
Idira ro hone lo hotelel.
When you are faithful,
out separala,
you get a fruit of enduring.
O thola dienywa cha o hotelela.
Number three.
Sabrar.
When you are faithful,
out separala,
hope is established because of love. You start to have a fruit of love. And that love opens your spiritual eyes to see hope in the future. To see in the future. The faith people can see in the future. What makes you to be faithful is because you are seeing in the future. You know God will never leave you or forsake you. He's going to bless you at the end. When I want to hear God speaking with
you,
I normally check my faithfulness. The question is, are you faithful before God? Or are you faithful before people? I want you to pray with me today. If you want God to speak with you, check your faithfulness. Lift up your hands and say, Oh Lord, today expose my heart.
Today expose my heart.
Reveal to me
my weakness.
I want to confess that.
I want to confess.
Can you begin to pray?
Oh Lord,
today reveal to me. Pray that prayer. Reveal to me. Oh Lord, reveal to me. In Jesus' name. Amen. Many of us, we pretend to be faithful. And some of you pretend to be very strong. And this makes you to pretend. You end up pretending.
The
life that you are living, you live it with pretense. And this pretending issue, I'll say I love you, whereas inside you don't love. I'm not happy inside, but you are able to say, I'm happy. It makes you to be divided. Even God does not know which one to bless.
Between
the one who say happy, who's not happy inside. What we need now, we need the grace of God to be able to stand in the truth, to express our truth. If I'm weak
here,
I need help. We must not pretend to be strong. Lift up your hands and ask God to give you strength to live truthful life. Prayer. To live truthful life. God, give me strength. Oh, yes. Give me this grace, oh Lord.
to live truthful life, to be able to say you are wrong if it's wrong, you are right if it's right.